guys, I'm Alicia, and today I'd like to demonstrate the bridge pose to you. It's done a lot in yoga. It's great for your spine, it's great for your lower back and your back muscles. It strengthens it, it lengthens it, it works your butt, your hamstrings, and your core area. So we're gonna start it off with a supported bridge. My cameraman, Rob, is gonna tell me if the block is straight on my back, because it's really hard at times for me to see how the block is, and sometimes it tilts. So if you hear a man's voice, don't be scared. So we're gonna start off by doing a little warm-up. And with any exercise you do, you always wanna make sure that you are warmed up, so to prevent injury, even if it's just 5 minutes, that's fine. So we're gonna bring our heels really close to our butt area as best as we can. You want your chest to be on your thigh muscles, shoulders relax back and down, puff your chest up, straight in the back, inhale and exhale, really arch, spreading your shoulder blades, crunching your abs in really tight, inhale, come up, and exhale. Couple more times, inhale, and exhale. Last time, inhale, come up, sit up nice and tall, and exhale. So we're gonna roll back on our backs. Take a block, so we're gonna start off in a long, narrow position or narrow, tall position. So we'll start off in the shorter, longer position first. So we're gonna lean back, bring our heels close into our butt, make sure feet and everything is facing forward. Okay, you're gonna press your heels, bring your hips up, put the block right on your lower back. Okay, palms are gonna be facing up, shoulders relax, keep your abs in tight all the time, and feel
it's a little crooked
how this feels. It's a little crooked.
Yeah, just a little bit
this way.
Yeah, perfect.
Okay, and just breathe. You want to hold this for a couple of seconds, 30 seconds is fine.
Feet,
and you want to release.
Feet forward.
And then we're going to do
feet forward.
A little taller. So again, we're going to press our heels, hips up, and we're going to do it the long, tall way.
It's a little crooked.
Okay, it's a little crooked, he says. Is that good?
A little bit more.
More to my feet?
Yeah.
Good. Is that good?
Yeah.
All right. It's hard for me to tell. I need a mirror. And again, we're going to hold it right there and breathe. Just again for a couple of seconds. Close your eyes and relax. This really, really works, really stretches you out. Now we're gonna do it without the block. Again, toes, feet, everything facing forward. Heels close to your butt as best as you can. Contract your abs flush, flat into the mat. Palms facing up. You're gonna inhale and exhale. Press your feet into the floor, hips up. Hold it for a few seconds, breathing, and exhale down. Inhale, come up. And exhale here. One more time, inhale. And exhale down. You do that 3 times, 5 times if necessary. I'd say about 2 to 3 times. Bring your right and your left knee into your chest. Stretching out your lower back if you want. And breathe. Always move nice and slow. Do not rush anything. Listen to your body. So we're going to try wheel or high bridge. And again, this is a really intense back bend. If you can't do it, stick with the supported bridge or the regular bridge without the block if necessary. If you want to give the wheel a try, make sure you have your hair out of your way so you don't put your hands on it. You want to turn your palms down Fingers spread nice and wide. Elbows, biceps close into your head, into your body. So you're going to inhale. Make sure your toes, everything face forward. Exhale and arch your head on, arch your body to the top of your head. Sorry. Oh, right here. So get yourself supported. Inhale and exhale, press up. Straighten your elbows. Fingers nice, spread and wide. Really make sure your toes, everything is facing forward. If you could move back a little bit, move back. And breathe. Few more breaths. Tuck your head in and come down nice and slow. Palms again facing up. Bring your knees into your chest. And relax. And sit up. Again, this takes a lot of energy. It really works your lower back muscles. So again, if you cannot do the full wheel, do the supported bridge if necessary. You want to do that about 2 or 3 times. Again, with the wheel, if you're going to try that, you want to do that about 2 or 3 times. I would love to hear any feedback or comments that you may have. If there's any particular exercise that you would like me to demonstrate and for you guys to see, I can do that. Hope you guys enjoy. See you again next time. Bye.